Hi everyone, my name is Nupur and we are here today with the Super Hoopers show by the Hoopsters League of Action Heroes. This is a program where we talk to children who are doing some incredible things out there that are making a small difference or a big difference in the world. The idea is to celebrate the change makers of tomorrow, which are our children, and to inspire other children to take similar action and make the world a better place. And today we have with us Nishchit. Hi, Nishchit.
Hi, ma'am.
Nishchit, can you tell us a little bit about yourself? Which school are you from? How old are you?
Ma'am, myself, Nishchit Asach. I am studying in 9th class. I am 15 years old and I am studying in Kumati Residential Central School, Shikaripura.
Okay. So, Nishchit, you submitted your article to Hoopsters. How did you come to know about Hoopsters? Who told you about it?
Our principal, ma'am.
Okay, your principal told you about Hoopsters, is it? And yes, what did she tell you?
It is a very nice place where we can get encouraged and we have get motivation to do social services.
Okay, so you entered the Super Hooper contest. Do you understand what Super Hooper is for? What is the contest all about? Can you explain to us in your own words?
Ma'am, it is a stage where we can present our social services that all people are seeing that they also start that social services.
Okay. So, Nishchit, what I have seen in your article or what you submitted to us is that you have done something to help women in your village become self-sufficient.
Yes, ma'am.
And for somebody who is just 15 years old, that is quite incredible. So, can you tell us a little bit about what you have done?
Ma'am, I had made show pieces, gift items and vessels by using tamarind seeds and waste paper, ma'am.
Okay, and how did this help the women in the village?
Ma'am, when I went to my granny's village, there I saw many plight of women. Mm-hmm. Their husbands were daily wage workers.
Okay.
When they earn money, they all spent on drinking alcohol only, ma'am.
Okay.
So, they were moving to the house in an inebriated state. They doesn't take the money to their house.
Mm-hmm.
And if their wives asked their questions, they started beating them.
Okay.
So, I had made a plan to that type of families, ma'am.
And how did you help them with whatever you had made? You said you made, pots and cups and all of that. How did that help the women?
Ma'am, I started to teach them how to make vessels and all by using tamarind seeds and waste paper. They mm-hmm. learned that, ma'am. After that, they are sold in market. They got a very price, ma'am. Okay. And they can maintain their home needs, ma'am.
Okay, and how did you get this idea, Nishchit?
From my grandmother, ma'am.
So, does your grandmother also do this? Does she also make things using tamarind seeds and waste paper?
She is making, ma'am, but she does not teach to others.
Okay. And tell me one thing, why did this thought come to your mind? As in, how did you, what made you want to take this step?
In my granny's village, there are some people, those who are daily wage workers, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
When evening they earn money, they entirely spend on drinking alcohol only.
Okay. Right.
And they went to their house with an empty hand.
Okay.
And their wives were asking them, where is the money? And they started beating them, ma'am.
And have you seen any of them being beaten or you have seen it yourself?
Yes, ma'am.
And did this idea come to you from your parents or from your grandmother or anybody from your home? Or was it completely your thought that I should help these women somehow?
My thought, ma'am.
It was your thought. That's a wonderful thought, Nishchit. And now that you're seeing these women earning money by making these pots or making these vessels, how does it make you feel?
I'm feeling proud about myself, ma'am.
Okay, has anybody ever come and spoken to you about it and said, thank you so much for teaching us?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, they have. What is the best thing someone has told you?
Someone, ma'am, one lady, Her age is 35.
Okay.
She said that I am so thankful to you.
Okay. She came and told you personally that she is really thankful that you helped her.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, take care of her home. Nishit, why should more children like you take up such initiatives? Why is it important for children to take part? Because we know adults are doing it. But why should youngsters do it?
Ma'am, to become a role model for others.
Okay. And has your action inspired any of your classmates or friends to do the same?
Yes, ma'am.
Give us some instances of how you have inspired your friends.
Ma'am, in my village, my neighbors are started to sing and they also joined me, ma'am. Joined with me.
Okay. And how many women have you taught to do all of this, Nishchit? How many of them are there?
In lockdown, I have nearly 100 to 150 wives I have taught, ma'am.
How did you go about doing this? Did you go from home to home or did you call them to one place and say, from now we'll meet here? How did you do it?
First, we give instructions to them that we have to meet in one place at a time.
Mm-hmm.
I took the class for them 1 week.
Okay. And they were okay with learning from a young boy like you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, they were okay. They were friendly with you and they learned. Did they learn fast?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what all do you make with tamarind? What did you say? Tamarind seeds, right?
Yes, ma'am. Tamarind seeds and waste paper.
So how do you use tamarind seed to make vessels?
First, we have to take some quantity of tamarind seeds.
Hmm.
And we have to soak it for an hour and for a day.
Hmm.
And we have to take same quantity of waste paper and we have to soak it for an hour.
Okay.
After that, we have to make a nice paste of it both, ma'am.
Okay.
The paste should be a little thicker one, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
By using this paste, we can make fancy items, gift, bowls, shows, statues, etc. in any shape.
Okay. So it's like, is it like clay? Does it look like clay when you make it?
It's like soil.
It's like soil. Acha, so it looks like wet soil that you can mold into any shape.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And then what do you do? Do they then paint it or do they make it look prettier and then sell it? Or do they sell it as it is?
Yes, ma'am.
What do they do? Do they paint it? Do they paint it and...
They will paint that, ma'am.
Okay. Nishchit, tell us one incident that you witnessed or you saw that made you want to start this initiative.
Ma'am, in my grandmother's house, ma'am.
Hmm.
My grandmother was doing like this, ma'am.
So you watched your grandmother?
I watched, ma'am.
And what did your grandmother do? How was your grandmother helping people in the village?
Ma'am, my grandmother was an artist, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
She is making a handcraft and a knickknackles.
Okay. And she teaches she doesn't teach anybody or she does teach them?
She teaches, ma'am.
She teaches people to make it and that's how she also is helping others.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Nishit, do you have plans to expand your project or make it bigger? Or do you plan to go back every year and teach? How do you plan to take this forward?
Yes, ma'am.
How do you want to take it forward? So how are you going to make this initiative bigger?
Ma'am, I have a target that I have to teach a lakh of women.
Okay, that's impressive. And how do you plan to do this? Are there 1 lakh women in your village?
No, ma'am.
So then how will you target 1 lakh women?
In vacations, I and my family were going to the different villages. Okay. And in that, we have to make a class, teaching class. And we have to train them, ma'am.
So how do you tell people about these classes, Nishchit? Now, in the village, they may not know about these things that are happening. So how do you make them aware of these workshops or classes that you're taking?
Ma'am, I am showing that, I giving examples, ma'am, that my grandmother's family and my grandmother's village neighbor's family.
Okay. And do you go to every house and tell them, okay, I'm doing a class or I'm doing, or do you put up posters? How do you communicate? You put posters. Okay, so you put posters, they read and they come.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so all your classes are going to be for 1 week, wherever you plan to teach them?
No, ma'am. That's their efficiency, capacity.
Okay, so you'll watch your group, see how fast they learn, and teach them till they learn.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Very, very impressive, Nishit. And what does your principal or your school have to say about this? Of course, your principal knows because she's the one who told us.
Yes, ma'am.
And she told you to pull it up. So what did she tell you about the work that you're doing?
A very nice idea that you have to keep in a young age.
Okay. And if you had to give your friends or your classmates some message saying, you know, how it feels to help others, what would your message be?
Ma'am, my message is they have to do social services like for poor peoples and all.
Okay. And do you plan to, get some friends to join you next time you go and take workshops? Is that something that you thought about? Have you already picked your friends who will join you?
My grandmother's neighbor's house people, I took that, ma'am.
So you already have people who are helping you for your next venture. Wow, that is amazing.
Nearly 50 members.
You have 50 people who are going to help you?
Yes, ma'am. We had made a team.
Wow. And what all does your team do besides teaching? Do they also go and educate the women, train them? What do 50 people do together?
Ma'am, for illiterate people and all, they train ma'am how to teach, how to write, how to sign, and how to read newspaper and all.
And you made this team of 50 people alone?
Yes, ma'am.
Wow.
With my grandmother and my mother's support.
With your grandmom and your mother's support. Okay.
Yes.
And how are your parents? Of course, I'm sure your parents are supportive about this, but how did your parents inspire you to become the person you are, Nishit?
Ma'am, my mother had an idea about this type. We have to make a group and we have to do social services to the peoples.
Okay, so she has been teaching you this from a young age.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Nishit, is there any other initiative that you have taken similar to this?
Yes, ma'am. I have planted so many trees and I have gifted some trees to the plantations and all, ma'am.
Okay, and how old were you when you started doing this kind of work?
Ma'am, at the age of 5, with my mother, I started to do this type of work, ma'am.
Wow, that's really nice, Nishit. And I hope there are more kids like you. Okay, and tell us why, what makes you a super hooper?
Ma'am, can you please repeat once again?
You took part in a super hooper contest, right? So why are you a super hooper?
Why I am a super hooper?
Yes.
Ma'am, because I think that I had a plan. I think that I had made this type of ideas that other can do like this.
Okay, so you're a super hooper because you can inspire other people to follow in your footsteps and probably make a difference to not just 1 lakh, but a lot more people in the world. Isn't that right?
More than that, ma'am.
I really hope you touch your target of 1 lakh. That is a very impressive number. And
thank you, ma'am.
That you're just 15 years old. I mean, hats off to you, ma'am. Very good job. You have a team of 50. 50 is like a almost like a company, right? So
yes,
for you to have so many people, for you to actually train them, to train others at the age of 15, you're definitely a super hooper, Nishit.
Yes,
and I wish you a lot of good luck and keep sharing your progress. We want to know what you're up to, how you're doing these things. Okay, please keep us in the loop. All right.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Nishit. I hope to see more of your articles.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you for being with us.
Thank you, ma'am.